And for the latest on the ground in Egypt, Margaret Warner spoke by phone a short time ago with John Ray. He's another of ITN's correspondents in Cairo.
John Ray reporting from Cairo. We've just heard this dramatic announcement from President Mubarak that he's asked his whole government to resign. There's going to be a whole new government in place tomorrow. Has there been any reaction yet?
I think it's far too early. There are still, even at this late hour, it's midnight 30 here in Cairo, a large number of people on the streets. We are hearing the sounds of battle in the distance from our hotel room. There is still tear gas being fired, baton rounds as well. I think the reaction, though, when they do hear the news will be one of great disappointment, because remember, these protesters really have a load of complaints about unemployment, about high prices, but it all coalesces around one demand, and that is for Mubarak to go. And Mubarak isn't going. He's still there. He's still saying tonight that I'm the man in charge and I'm staying.
Now, he was offering the opportunity to communicate. He kept saying, you know, not through violence, but we can communicate about these grievances. Is there a leader of these protests? Are there opposition leaders to communicate with who would step forward if this is a genuine offer?
Well, the problem is, of course, there is a great deal of leadership in the opposition, too much leadership, you might say. There are moderate reformers like Mohammed al-Baradei, the former UN nuclear watchdog chief, a reasonable man, a diplomat, a moderate reformer, a man maybe that Mubarak could do business with. But the problem is al-Baradei has no constituency here. And then there's a Muslim Brotherhood. Now, they are probably the most organized of the opposition groups, but they're not legal. They are sort of tolerated, but they are illegal, so it's difficult to think of him doing business with that group of people. So, I think the real difficulty here is to believe that President Mubarak is offering any kind of significant compromise. This is a man who has made a career out of inflexibility. To do anything otherwise, he is breaking the habit of a presidency.
Now, when you talk to leaders of any of these protests, do you get a sense that they would stand back and let somebody negotiate with the government?
I can't believe that will happen. There is only one chant, there is only one slogan, there is only one thing that they shout out on the streets, and that is that Mubarak must go. They want a new president, they want a new system, that he has got to go. It seems to them they would be sitting down with the very devil.
Now, he also, of course, strongly emphasized the security of the state, how he wasn't going to let fear run his country. The army came in this afternoon, as you all reported today. How aggressive are their tactics?
It's really hard to say. I've watched tonight as row upon row of armored vehicles rolled towards the main central square in this city, not just armored personnel carriers, but tanks. We counted one, two, three, four, many, many tanks heading that way. At the same time, there's no sign yet of them opening fire on anybody, which I suppose would be a dramatic way of restoring some kind of government control to the streets of Cairo. But of course, I think that would open up a whole hornet's nest. But the army's position now is pivotal. Mubarak is relying on them. He needs their support. The army, I think if the Egyptian army thought that Mubarak's continuing presidency damaged their cause, and that is particularly significant in relationship to aid packages from the United States, and I think they may do as the army in Tunisia did to their president and say, listen, it's time to go.
Have the protesters been reacting differently to the army than they did to the police, where they've been attacking police vehicles, for example?
There's been a real mixture of reaction. I have seen scenes of protesters pelting armored vehicles with missiles as they passed. But in other parts of the city, we've seen a row of army trucks moving in, and they're being mobbed and welcomed by the people, an attempt to bring them on side. The army is more popular here than the absolutely hated police and security forces, who have been making themselves even more unpopular as every day of protests has continued here.
Now, before President Mubarak spoke, what were the opposition's plans or the protesters' plans for tomorrow?
I'm not sure they were thinking beyond today, to be honest with you, Margaret. This was the second big day of a week of protests, you know, a week of unprecedented protests, which culminated in truly momentous scenes in Cairo. I cannot think they have made plans for tomorrow, except perhaps to do the same thing again, though not on this scale. They'll have the army parked on the streets, tanks parked on the streets. It will make things more difficult for them. And of course, the internet is still down here. Mobile telephone communications have been severed. Egypt is a communications black spot at the moment, so it'll be difficult to organize in that sense. But seeing what they did today without the help of social media is pretty impressive.
John Ray of ITN News, thank you so much.